Hey guys, Scare9 here, welcome back to my channel today, and the latest update to Destiny 2 just launched, and with it came a lot of really important changes to the raid system, and specifically how raid armor now works. So in this video, we're going to be taking a look at all of the brand new mods and perks added to the raid armors, and then I'm going to be giving my general thoughts and opinions on them. Now just a disclaimer, right off the front, all three armor sets, whether it be the base Leviathan set, the prestige armor set from the Leviathan, or the base Eater of Worlds armor set, they all three contain the same brand new mods to be equipped on the same pieces of armor. So to start off, let's go ahead and take a look at the helmet. This one has a selection between three exclusive mods, and they say while on the Leviathan, activating your super recharges your grenade. Now there is a Solar Arc and Void variant, so you don't have one perk for all three, but that shouldn't be too bad since most people tend to stick to one subclass. For instance, I'm pretty much always a Celestial Nighthawk Gunslinger, so of course I'm only gonna have the Solar variant of this mod activated on my Hunter. Now the next one is going to be the arms. This one has a selection of three fairly unique perks. One is called Striking Hand. While on the Leviathan, your melee kills increase all damage by 20%. Shielded Hand. While on the Leviathan, your melee kills reduce incoming damage by 20%. Or Giving Hand. While on the Leviathan, your melee kills have a chance to make enemies drop power ammo. Now I'm probably always going to be running Giving Hands. I don't know about you guys, but for my team, we are always consistently low on power ammo. So I think while Striking Hand is definitely something very powerful, I think that extra source of power ammo is definitely going to be a necessity, especially in those prestige mode encounters. So the next one we're going to be talking about is the chest piece, and it comes with the exclusive mod Heavy Hitter. While on the Leviathan, using power weapons to defeat challenging enemies will boost your power weapon damage by 15% for a short time. Notice it does specifically point out challenging enemies, so I'm guessing this means whenever you kill a major enemy, like a Centurion, like a Minotaur, you will then get a boost to your power weapon damage, which you can in turn use against a boss or a large group of enemies. I would definitely think that this is more useful on the Eater of Worlds encounter during the Argos fight. Maybe you are one of the ad clearers, so right before they pop the shield on Argos, you go ahead, you take out a Minotaur with your rocket launcher, so as soon as the shield is dropped, you have a couple of boosted rockets to shoot at Argos. Now the next armor pieces are the boots and their perks Energized. This one makes it so that while you are on the Leviathan, using energy weapons to defeat normal enemies will boost your energy weapon damage by 15% for a short time. But notice once again, it is only activated by killing a specific type of enemy, in this case normal enemies, which I assume refers to any regular red bar. So I think this one will be pretty much useful in every encounter, especially if you are using something like the Cold Heart or the Uriel's Gift or just a really solid energy weapon. But I also think a very good strategy would be during Kallus, whenever you are out of your rocket ammo and you're stuck with your Cold Heart or whatever in that slot, if you look down and kill a dog really quickly, because they will probably be considered normal enemies, then you look up and you will do more damage to Kallus for a short amount of time. That just seems like it will be a very good strategy to use during the Kallus encounter. And then the final item with a brand new exclusive mod is going to be the class item, and this one is called the Emperor's Elemental perk. While on the Leviathan, your abilities of a specific type deal 25% more damage, and then you can have a Arc, Solar, or Void variant of this as well. Once again, I don't know if this will function on your supers. Initially, you would think that it would, but on the other hand, I can't really see them letting Celestial Nighthawk Hunters do even more damage than they already do. So that's something I will have to test in tonight's raid. But overall, I think all of these mods are a fantastic start to this system. Now, should a system like this have been in place since the beginning of Destiny 2? Yeah, sure, an argument could probably be made that it should have been. But just be happy that we got it now. All of these are fantastic perks. They're all very powerful. They will make the raid not only much easier, but much more enjoyable, and they will make us feel even more powerful while participating in these activities. And I cannot wait to see what they do with the next raid layer. If the next armor set's gonna have similar perks, if there's gonna be even more, that's something I'm definitely looking forward to. So overall, if you do have any of these sets, I would definitely recommend using the raid exclusive perks versus some of the other perks. It does cost one Kallus token to apply them, and every time you switch them around, it will take one more Kallus token. But overall, I think they're well worth it, and I cannot wait to try them out. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Let me know what you thought about all of these brand new mods down in the comment section below. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to leave a like rating and to share it with your friends. If you are interested in watching either of the two videos on screen, including part one of my collab with Datto, you can click their respective annotations to be taken to them. If you are brand new to my channel, make sure to hit the giant version of my logo on screen to be subscribed to more awesome Destiny 2 videos and live streams. Thank you guys so much for watching today, and I will see you in my next video.